Hello and welcome back to my channel. In today's Salesforce video, I'm going to talk about date fields in Salesforce and how to assign a default value in date fields. Right, so if you can take a few seconds to give a like to this video to support my efforts, that would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. This is the setup and configuration section of Salesforce. This is where all development efforts take place. If you log into Salesforce and you're not immediately taken to this page, again, you can click on this gear icon and click on setup, and you will be taken to setup and configuration. All right. So you will remember from my other videos that I had created a Lightning app that's called Speedy Sales. This is only for demonstration purposes. That does not really exist. Again, this Lightning app has two custom objects. One of them is purchase orders and the other one is products. So in this video, let's go ahead and add a date field to our purchase order. This is the page layout of our purchase order. So as you can see, we have an order date and time. So this is the date and time of the order. And say that when the purchase order, this record actually is created, we would like to automatically assign a delivery date, which does not exist right now on the page layout. This is something that we're going to create together. And then assign a default value that's 15 days from now. And now meaning the moment that this record is created. But obviously you can extrapolate actually that scenario. You don't have to say the moment that the record is created. You can set other criteria. The moment that order was confirmed, but this will give you the basics of how to define, how to assign a default value to the date field. First of all, let's create our date field. So let's go back to setup and configuration, and let's locate our custom object in which we're going to create our date field. So there you go. Purchase order, and then we navigate to fields and relationships, and here let's create a date field that's called, okay, it's not going to be date time, it's going to be date because it's a delivery date. So let's say actually, let's call this a delivery due date. So this is the date, this is the maximum, this is the latest delivery date for this purchase order, right? So latest date or latest delivery date for the purchase order. All right. So let's actually add this as help text as well, so that it appears on this little information icon. All right, so this is where all the magic happens. So in this default value for this delivery due date, we're going to write today. Today is a function basically, right? Plus 15. So this, actually, you can see it here in the example that Salesforce itself is giving as well. You can see it here written really, really small. I will try to make it bigger actually. I'm not sure if I can. Oh, I can. Yes. There you go. So even in the help field, you see Salesforce is giving a similar example. So this is the format that you would like to use. All right, let's just zoom out and, so we will say today plus 15. Remember, you don't want to use a formula field here. So what is the difference between a formula field and a date field with a default value in it? So formula field is not stored in the database. It's calculated actually. The value that you see inside a formula field is calculated real time based on criteria based on other data fields. And there's a bunch of things actually that you cannot do with formula fields. And probably in this context, the danger with a formula field is that if you write today plus 15 in a formula field, the value will always change because it's always going to calculate the current today value plus 15 days. So if you create a formula field for this purpose, your value inside is dynamically going to change. It's going to change every single day, basically. Every time a day passes, the value is going to change as well. However, here, you're creating a date field with a default value. So what does this mean? This means that when you create a new record, Salesforce is going to write once and only once at the very beginning this default value inside. But then it's not going to dynamically update. Salesforce is not going to change the value in this field. This value is going to be written once with at that moment's today value, and that's it. It's not going to be dynamically updated. So this is the major difference between using a date field with a default value and a formula field, which you should not use in this context. All right, so let's say next. All right, so let's make this visible to all profiles. Next. And yes, I would like to place this on my page layout. So let's do something else. So if we're saying basically that we would like to assign a due date for the delivery, so maybe we should actually make this read-only as well. Because this is going to be one of our quality indicators, right? Logistics quality indicators, maybe. Let's make this read-only. So what does this do? It means that every time I create a purchase order, Salesforce is going to print a value inside that the user is not going to be able to change. Okay, so now that we have created our date field, we placed it on our page layout and we made it read-only, let's see how it behaves actually on the user interface. Now, this is a window where I logged in as a speedy user. You will know what this is if you watched my other video about profiles and permission sets. So this is just a regular user for this Lightning app. Now, if I click on new purchase order, right, so immediately you will see that a delivery due date has been populated by Salesforce with the default value formula that we entered in the date field, and it's read-only. Okay, so what happens is this date is not going to change. Tomorrow or the day after, it's not going to dynamically change or update it, okay? And this will remain on this form as a reference. So the moment this purchase order was created, this delivery due date was set and it's not going to move, and this will be the indicator if the delivery was the delivery occur before this due date or if it was actually past due date. So amazing customer order quantity 4, and you can also populate this order date immediately by today. So that's also one option. That let's do it together. But let's not lock that, because maybe the person is entering the information into the system a little bit late. However, what we can do is order date. And right, so let's edit. And then here, let's show the formula editor. And you will see that there are date and time functions. And what we want to do is date time value of today. And let's check the syntax. Okay, no errors found. Why is my formula different here? Because my data field is different. You will see that this delivery due date is a date field. However, the order date is a date time field. What today returns is just the date, right? Without further manipulation. If I add this function, date time value of today, then it's going to be the date time format that this data field is expecting. Perfect. So let's save. Let's cancel this. Remember, I did not make this field read-only, which means that this field is populated with the formula that I have just defined here, right? However, the person who is entering the order information can freely change. But they cannot change the delivery due date. This is a read-only field now. Okay, so amazing customer order, and the quantity is 4. I'll just leave it as it is because the order came in really today. So order type consumer order, and this is for North America, and I will just save this. All right, great. So now you see that I can change the other fields, but not delivery due date because this is read-only. And again, this date is not going to dynamically change, neither this one, because they're not formula fields, okay? Right, so I hope that it has been useful to you to understand how we can assign a default value to a date field. Actually, we covered both date and datetime fields, right? So you can base this actually on other criteria than just today. So you can have other references to base your formula on. This was just a simple demonstration of how to do it. So for your own scenario, you can use other references than today. All right. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel, it would be great help and support. Thank you, and see you in another video.